Well, dwellings are, you know, obviously important. I mean, we need shelter. Humans need shelter, and we need to feel safe when we're not out and about. And a lot of energy and love and time, thought goes into building dwellings so that people are comfortable and safe and happy in those spaces. I think we underestimate the importance of the action of building. Although in this business, in the high performance home building business, passive house building business, we find that our clients are all very tuned in to that aspect and really interested in what we're doing because it is an intimate process.
I'm Logan Ates, and I've lived in Bozeman about 10 years on and off. Met this lovely lady about 5-6 years ago, mm-hmm. and got married 3 years ago. And see, it's been 4 years ago now that we bought this land, and we have been kind of putting everything we have, all our energy and all our savings towards finishing it up this year, and super excited to be here and super excited to have it almost complete.
Yeah. My name's Andrea, and I moved to Bozeman in 2012 for a teaching job. We're both teachers. Finally getting the building and being in the building and seeing how we'll live with the building has been really fun.
As a company, we came to prefab because my hands were cold and I didn't want to work outside anymore. You know, I hate to say that the current iteration of collective carpentry is born out of me just being a wimp, but the reality is I think that is a universal problem in our industry. You know, we live in the northern part of North America, and the building climate is really challenging. It's really hot in the summer, it's really cold in the winter, and we might have 3 months out of the year that's really conducive to doing really high quality work at the highest level.
When we first started this side of the company, we were trying to make our building experience better. That was one of the primary reasons why we started building Prefab, because we were already building high performance homes for people. So building a high performance home, you know that somebody's going to live in a home that is warm, draft free, that is healthy, you know, it has really nice indoor air quality, and that it's going to last a really long time. So that's always the primary goal. Everything we do is to provide a quality home for someone. We have always built custom homes, and we started off especially building custom homes. But it was always our plan right from the beginning to have pre-designed homes. It was immediately identified that the planning and design part of this business was expensive. And it needs to be expensive because we're building and we're designing and prefabbing and installing a ton of value in a short amount of time. So the planning process is absolutely vital. But it was always identified that if we could leverage the planning process over multiple projects, we will therefore be bringing the cost per project down.
I love working with Collective. When we started deciding to build a home and started the process of hunting for an architect and a builder, my dad was always like, building a home is one of the most stressful things a marriage can go through. That's what he was constantly reminding us, as though like, don't worry, it'll get better. But it hasn't been, that side of things at least, hasn't been stressful at all. Yeah. They respected our limitations financially, but they didn't make us feel like they were limitations.
Yeah, I think the big thing is just being able to break down the barriers to the end user. You know, whether the end user is a general contractor or a homeowner. Building a house has a lot of different processes to it. And if we can eliminate some of those or make them easier, then that whole home building sequence just becomes a less daunting task to all the people involved. We're able to get more people in better homes. They get in there faster and they have to jump through fewer hoops.
a growing company, so we're learning things every day and developing policy and approaches and communicating with people. It's an active business, which is cool, really cool. You know, it takes a team to make things like this happen, and that feels good.
It is mostly about the people that we're surrounded by. I think we would have closed the book on collection carpentry a number of years ago if we didn't have the amazing team that we have surrounding us. We are building high performance homes, so it's going to be a really airtight building, so we're delivering all the airtightness aspects to it. We're also delivering a lot of extra insulation over top of a typical code-built building. Wall R values typically fall in kind of a low R50 range. We're also delivering the exterior weather barrier. That includes a nice European-made exterior membrane and then also strapping for siding in a rain screen fashion. So the total package, it really captures 4 or 5 different sub-trades, and we are delivering the design portions of that and also the installation portions of that. So really at the end of our scope, we like to deliver an airtight, weathertight, and mostly insulated building envelope that can be turned over and ready for the sub-trades that come after us.
So it's an easy process, really. You pick the model, shop builds the place, and then we install it. I mean, this place went up in 3 days, I think.
Yeah.
With maybe a day or two of some structural connections and air sealing. I mean, it's super fast, super efficient.
They just have it so dialed in. And that's on this one, which is the first of that floor plan for collective homes. So I can only imagine how much faster, and they're gonna find even better ways to do things. And it was built in a sealed in structure, so we know that the builders were comfortable when they were building, so they're not trying to just get something done because it's really uncomfortable. They took time with their craft.
Knowing that this was our first CC home that we were going to deliver to a client, that made it even more important to work through the design process as thoughtfully and thoroughly as possible. So working with Heather closely to help her manage some things like ideal panel sizes and lengths of walls and roof slopes and connections was really important. But I think more important was trying to meet the client's goals, because we knew that we were going to always find ways to change and to make minor adaptations to the design, and that will continue to happen over time. But it was really important for us to have the eights happy and to have them really pleased with their new home. So that was the primary goal. So with collective homes, they are designed to be certified passive house in most situations. So there will be, climate appropriate levels of insulation. There will always be passive house airtightness, the airtightness standard of 0.6 ACH. We will always meet that.
Passive house and high performance building is often seen at face value as just an energy saving method, which it is. It obviously is, and that is shown in the data. But I think in the day-to-day life of living in a high-performance home, it's a really comfortable space to be in. It's really quiet. The temperatures are even.
The home's footprint is basically a square, but when you're inside, you don't feel like you're a square. You don't feel like you're living in a box.
It's a really comfortable space to just be in. It's somewhere that you can hear your thoughts, but not to the point of them overwhelming you. Significantly cooler inside the structure without air conditioning, just with the walls and the windows, than it is outside. So when it's 80 or 90 outside, we can go inside and it feels like a break from the heat.
We like the way it's kind of oriented on the hill with the windows showcasing the really nice views and the light and the passive solar that we gain from the south.
It's a space where when you're sitting inside and relaxing, it almost invites and encourages you to step outside and enjoy it as well. It's a thoughtful design. We're tickled pink.
It's no secret that we're in a climate emergency, and I feel like, well, it's not like I feel like, it's well known that construction is a huge contributor to that problem. We're really trying to be a part of the solution rather than continuing to be part of the problem.
The house becomes an heirloom. You know, we used to talk about building houses, a 100-year house. You want a house to last 100 years, but I think we could probably talk about a 200-year house now. And so the investment and the thought that goes into a house like this, it becomes an heirloom that's passed down, certainly.
That feels really special for us, to be held with that responsibility on our shoulders.
What's up, everyone?
Hey, fans.
Happy Friday. Rain here. And Paul. Hashtag install legend. We are in Bozeman, Montana. We're back at the project that we installed here early June, late May. When were we here?
June.
Yeah. Early June. So this is the first of many pre-designed collective homes. And as part of the collective home package, we supply and install windows and doors. So we installed the windows and doors. All the holes are filled. We're using these nice Alpen windows and doors, good European hardware, very high performance units. They're all in their holes. They're all taped up. We hope you guys enjoy your weekend and come out strong for Monday. We will check back in a week or two. No guarantees I'm going to do this every week, you guys. Keep you on your toes. Hope you're all well. Take care. See you soon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully you're not hearing my stomach. Are you hearing my tummy right now? I gotta eat a bagel. My stomach is just like, sorry if that is getting in the way.
The perfect quote shit. With a stomach grumble in it.
That good.
Just subliminal.
Oh, man.
It's like, man.
It's embarrassing.
I want a passive house and a bagel.
I want a passive house and a bagel. Great, yeah.
Guys,